Welcome to Audio Video System Playlist. I, Professor Hitesh Dholakia, is going to explain gross structure of television. So in this session, I'll explain few standards of gross structure of television. Then I'll explain some videos format, how to play that in different TVs, and what are the advantages and how things are getting displayed on television. So that is what we will discuss in this session. So to explain this session, these are my session outlines. So first, I'll be explaining basics of gross structure of TV. Then we will see some standards which is there with gross structure of TV. Then after, I'll explain reasons for why we choose horizontal width larger than the height. So these are my session outlines. So let us begin this session with first agenda, that is basics of gross structure of television. Now see, when you see any television, you will be finding its structure is rectangular in shape. And width to height ratio, that is referred as aspect ratio. So all the televisions that you will be finding, it is rectangular in shape. And width to height ratio, that is referred as aspect ratio. So here in most of the television, you'll be finding aspect ratio is 4:3. There are some television which is having aspect ratio that is even 16:9. But most of the television that you will be finding, it is having aspect ratio that is 4:3. It is not necessary to send signal from transmitter to receiver with same size, but it is so essential to maintain same aspect ratio. Otherwise what will happen is, like, you'll be finding images are looks like too thin or too wide. So for that, I'll give you one example so it will be more clear. Like, you can see we have one original image over here. So some beautiful ladies are there, and you can see the size of this all females which is there in this image. And if you have aspect ratio which is bit wider than the original image, in that case you will be finding all these females looks little fat, right? Why? The reason is horizontal width is stretched over here. So you will be finding, as if you stretch this image horizontally, all the people and all the objects which is there in this image will be bit wide. And if you observe with this aspect ratio, where I have reduced horizontal dimensions, so in that case you'll be finding all the people, those who are there in this image, that is looking bit thin, right? So aspect ratio matters a lot. Here one thing that we need to understand: when you transmit a data and you can receive it, so in both of the cases, it is not compulsory to send signal with same size and same aspect ratio. But it is so essential to maintain aspect ratio. Why? The reason is, if you stretch it bit with wider frame, in that case you'll be finding objects are a bit wide. And if you reduced horizontal dimensions, in that case objects will be bit thin. So that will happen, and that will be making image unnatural. So this may be the case which can happen. Now let us see some standards which is there with television, so it will be more clear. Basic standards for TV with aspect ratio is 4:3, but as HD TV have evolved in television, you'll be finding aspect ratio is chosen to be 16:9. So 16:9 aspect ratio, that is there with HD TV. I'll give you a few examples so it will be a bit more clear. Now you can see here I have considered four different TVs, and all TVs are having size of 55 inch. So you can see this TV that is of 55 inch, this TV that is even of 55 inch. So all four TVs, that is there with dimension of 55 inch. And with 55 inch TV over here, with this case, if I have, now see, 55 inch TV with 4:3 aspect ratio is there. With this 55 inch TV, 16:9 aspect ratio is there. With this 45 inch TV, 16:9 aspect ratio is there. And with this 55 inch TV, 4:3 aspect ratio is there. Right. Now, all I'll be doing is I'll consider a case of HD video. Now, all this TV are HD TV. And for this TV, if I consider 1080 pixel video. So for 1080 pixel, if I give you example of 4:3 standard, in that case resolution will be 1440 cross 1080. So for 4:3 standard resolution of 1080 pixel, that is 1440 cross 1080. And with 16:9, that resolution will be 1920 cross 1080. Now see, when you play this 1080 pixel video with 4:3 standard in 55 inch 4:3 aspect ratio, so in that case, if you play this 4:3 standard, means resolution is 1440 cross 1080. So in that case, you'll be finding this video will be completely fit on this display. So there is no blank area which is there in this entire TV. You can see it. But when this 4:3 standard resolution of 1080 pixel, that you play it in 16:9 ratio of television, in that case, you'll be finding there are blank zone which is over here, right? And that is happening because of this video that is fitting over here in center. And see, this 1040, that explains you vertical resolution, right? And this 1080, that explains you horizontal resolution. So horizontal resolution, that is fitting over here, but vertical resolution is not getting fit. You can see it over here, right? So see, blank strips, that is happening as per standard 4:3, right? So 4:3 video is there and TV is of 16:9. Now, second case that I have shown it over here, that is for television of 4:3, but video that I have considered it for 16:9. So for 16:9 standard, if I consider 1080 pixel, then that will be 1920 cross 1080. Now see, for this case, now aspect ratio, that is bit horizontal, right? And you can see clearly 1920 cross 1080. So that is bit horizontal compared to this one. So here you'll be finding there is horizontal strips, which is blank strips. So this video cannot exactly getting fit to this entire TV. So you'll be finding this blank strips are there because of this reason. And if you have television with aspect ratio of 16:9, and if video is of 1080 pixel with 16:9 standard, in that case, complete video will get fit. So this is how things are happening. So we need to understand what type of TV that we have, and based on that only we should be watching video in that TV. Otherwise, you'll be finding blank strips are there. So this black color blank strips that you will be observing in even your mobile as well as on TV, and that is happening because of this reason. So this gross structure of television, that is so essential that we need to understand, right? Now let us discuss few reasons why do we select higher horizontal dimension. So in 4:3 as well as in 16:9, we have seen horizontal dimensions are greater compared to the vertical dimension. So why do we do that, and why do we have it in television? So see, in real world, you'll be finding almost all motions that is happening in horizontal plane, right? There are very rare motions which is happening in vertical plane. Like you'll be observing cars are moving on the road, people are walking on the road, people are running on the road, somebody is teaching you on video. So everything that is happening horizontally. There are very rare motions like rocket launching. So that is happening in vertical plane. So very rare motion is happening in vertical plane. So our mindset is used to have horizontal motions, and vertical motions are very rare. Secondly, when you observe our eye structure, then muscles of our eye is having more flex, is having is used to and comfort with horizontal motion when you see any object from left to right or right to left, right? But when it happens from top to bottom, in that case we need to move our neck even, right? So eyes can view with more ease and comfort when you see width of the picture more than its height. So this is what the basic thing that you will be observing. Like, consider a case when very short person is watching a person is having greater height. So at that time, that person need to watch it by stretching his neck. So that you will be observing, right? So this is what about the basic thing which is happening with human, and that's why horizontal dimensions are more compared to vertical dimensions. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for watching this video. I would like to get your suggestions from your side. The reason is I want all those topics that has to be covered on my channel so that students can easily learn everything which is required in their university courses. And you can download all this material which I am teaching here from my application Engineering Funda. So I am providing all those material free of cost. You can download it. It will be easier to you to learn all those topic which I am teaching here. Again, thank you so much for watching this video, and your suggestions are most welcome to me. So please do give your valuable suggestions, which is highly required here to optimize this channel.